Hello. Good afternoon. It is about 5 minutes to 7 p.m. on Friday, August 3rd, 2018, and we are making indie games. I'm not entirely sure where I was last time we left off, but I think the lion's share of this week was spent on this stuff. This is the sliding levels that lead up to the dance stage. The idea here being that Euler's like building a little dance stage, and I don't know exactly how that'll pop up, but I know the levels I want there. And I just need like a couple of quick tutorial levels to lead you into it. And I am most of the way there. I'm just finishing up some stuff, so I'll show you what that looks like. Right now, real quick. For posterity. So before, this was a little bit less fleshed out, and there's a gaping hole right here. Now, we have some entry levels. Can figure out how that changes. Why does the music randomly change there? Here's where we are. This is where I left off. There's a lot of stuff that went into the other. See how when you change from moving on one platform to another, the materials change? I need to do a bit of work there to make that make a little more sense. For this level specifically. This art's super temp. I know I want them to be sliders that slide up and down. I don't know why that's showing up double. I need to fix that. And I need to set it so you can actually win this, because you can't right now. Also, I need to come up with a solution for that, which I think is pretty simple. So let's just start with the really easy stuff here, shall we? I need to blow a hole in this. I actually don't need this to be here, so that's fine. Anyway, yeah. Today we'll be finishing that. Before we go to sleep, this will be done. I thought the fly was gone and the fly is back. You know what? Flies are good for the environment, probably. I imagine. That's probably true. My favorite insect. That's a lot of pretty cool insects. That's actually a difficult one. This fly is cocky as shit. So anyway, flies do like bright lights, and I'm don't know why I keep only flies towards my face when I'm streaming. That's interesting. The decision of that. Anyway, so we're breaking a hole into this. Step one. Let's make sure I'm in the right submap real quick. This would be funny if I wasn't so pissed. You have no idea how distracting that is. I'm gonna open the window. God. So anyway. I hope I was talking to the fly, otherwise that was a very disturbing thing to say. The people who are watching this on YouTube later are gonna have no idea what the fuck that was about, and that's fine. That'll be a mystery for them. So anyway. Sweet. Fixed. Next problem. So, what this is there's art when you're on the main screen that flips. Which, how do I put this? So, when I load the actual level, those are the gameplay sliders. When you're not actually in that level, it flips over to just being static meshes. And there's two different static meshes, one set for before you beat the level, one set for after. So what we need to figure out here is, why is it these are not hiding when you load the level? What did I do this morning that made that not work? Well, I just set this up like an hour ago, but art backdrop. So these are all the stack meshes that hide when the level's incomplete. These are what show when it's complete. They're all hidden by default. Yeah, so when you go into the sliding level... Oh, shit. Okay, so if you go directly into the sliding level, it'll hide them all, but if you... This is bound to the first time. Basically what I'm taking is I'm binding this event that hides all the static meshes to a call that happens on the game mode blueprint when the camera goes from level select into the level. I didn't try playing through the game level to level until now, and that's why I didn't notice this was broken. So what I need is there a callback on the game mode? Can I bind an event? Spellbind correctly. Combine an event to... Okay, there's nothing for when a level is loaded. Level load complete? Let me look at what that does. Content browser. Game mode. Yeah, at the end, with the current level name. Perfect. Okay. This is great. So, coming up, Gwen. Game. Level loaded. Yeah, level loaded. Okay, so this, the art backdrop that's holding these static meshes, when it's first loaded into the game, when that level is streamed in, it binds an event to the game mode that triggers every time a level is loaded. The loaded levels being the gameplay levels. I guess, I don't know if I ever explained this, but there's each little section that you beat is its own level that streams in and out, and it's invisible to the player. It just has all the gameplay logic in it. So you don't have, at any given time, you only have the gameplay logic for just the little area you're playing. And then there's the overworld. It's just one, well, it's like about 8 larger levels that have just art and static meshes, and that's loaded at basically all times. Because there's no logic there. It's just a bunch of polygons. Except for this logic, which is very little. So yes, when a gameplay level is loaded, when it's this gameplay level, we hide all the actors. Let's see if that's working. Hey buddy, why won't you save? There you go. Okay. Hey, Port Monkey, what's up, man? Long time to say, dude. Good. Oops. See, I gotta fix these shaders. I want you to win. So, I need to message to the player that they need to turn all the sliders on. And even more importantly, I need to detect when that happens and say that you've won the level. I have no idea how I'm gonna do that yet. Why do you feel rejected, Propuke? I don't talk about flies and arachnids and such. I don't think I have a favorite insect. I think as human beings we naturally... we like mammals more. Bugs are gross. I suppose if I had to choose an insect, I would choose something like a lobster, because those are tasty. Whereas other bugs mostly irritate me. I think it would have to be that. Lobster. I'm not sure if it counts as an insect. It has insect-like qualities. I will say I'm firmly against soft-shell crab. I feel, though it is supposedly a delicacy, it's disgusting. It tastes like eating a fingernail. I prefer my food to be prepared if I'm going to go out to eat and presented to me in a way that makes it look easy, you know, like I don't want to have to do a project. Whereas I feel like disassembling some sort of creature, like a lobster, would be my least favorite part. I prefer lobster tail when all the work has been done for you. And I am firmly against soft-shell crab. Was that enough information? Not insects don't count. God damn it. Thank you, Port Monkey, for standing solidly by my statement. I appreciate it. I always knew you were a true friend. So, how the fuck... You know, maybe for this, let's just one-off this whole level. I'm not gonna reuse this logic anywhere. I'm just not. How would I one-off it?
No.
Yeah, okay. This episode. Okay. Get me. Don't I have an activate? That's not gonna be useful. I just need like a base. Something that listens when it enters a grid tile. I have something like that already. Right? Game logic. Maybe I do. But I had something that listens, right? But that listens to the player. I want to listen to just actors. This is too one-off. I should just one-off it. I don't know why I'm fighting it. Alright, so I've got, like... Let's just get the bass volume. So this is something I made a while back. This is the master effect volume. Let's create a child class of it. We'll call it... Oh, shit. This is so one-off. It's gonna be, like, slider level. Completed. Check. Sure. Why not? You are. So you're a box. You're just really a box. Let's overwrite. There should already be an event on you for when an actor enters this box. That's why this exists. Something like... the master effect volume. Actor entered volume, yes. Oh, is it an interface call? To this, okay. So there should be actor entered volume. Let's call the parent. Not that I'm sure what that does. Nothing. It's just declared so I can pull off of it. That's cool. I'm still gonna call it, just in case. Alright, so do what's in the parent class. After that... Let's add an event dispatcher. Scream out to the world. Slider entered volume. And then let's also add a variable triggered. I guess I can't have both activated. Slider entered volume, that's fine, whatever. Okay. So when an actor entered the volume, it's only one actor could possibly be. Do I have anything for actor exited volume? Actually, I don't want this. I want a function that says check actor in volume. And what this does is, so on begin play, I want you to get, no. When something enters the volume, cast it to player pawn. Sorry, player pawn. Yes, good. From the player pawn, get the grid manager. Okay. Promote that to a variable, so I have it. Grid manager. Then. Check if an actor is in volume. What you'll do is, from the grid manager, world's position to, no, god damn it. World vector to grid index. The world vector being your location, vector location. Okay, now I have the grid index. On the grid manager, check, no, get tile. Give me everything else in this tile. Tile, come on, what do I call that function? I wrote this forever ago. Return grid tile data, yes. Give me everything in this. Break the contents of that struct. For each thing in this tile, cast it to grid, cast it to moving prop grid based. That seems right, yeah, sure. And if that succeeded, let's set a local variable, local prop found to be true. When that loop is complete, return. The output will be moving prop found. Okay, so now you have a function that returns if there's a moving prop in the same location that you are. You also have an event dispatcher that is set off when something enters this volume, right? Yes. No, I never called it. Let's call that. Okay, good manager, good. Good. So, let's set these. Not what I want. Slider level completed check. Okay, you are not grid snapping. Let's try that again. There we go. Of those, and then I want to take each of these. Let's go to the level blueprint. Oh, you better not be in the art backdrop. That's not where I want you. I want you in the level. Trombone sliding. Sorry, move selected actors to this level. Why not? For fuck's sake. Oops. Hey sniper, what's up, man? chat. Working on Psychonauts. That's the wrong depot. Okay, we're in. So, let's try that again. Good. So, I should be looking at references to these actors. Alright. On the level blueprint, on begin play. Is check actor and volume. I'm gonna make this pure. I call it return actor is in volume. Return sliding actor is in volume. If all of these are true, you've won. Okay, what does that mean? I think what I'll do in that case is get the game mode. This is a bit hacky. Get the current, cast game mode blueprint. Last but not least, set these to be invisible. Good. Thanks for chilling here, Sniper. It's good to see you, man. Psychonauts is fun. That was definitely, like, double fun. Everyone that works there is a very extroverted, and I don't know, they all kind of have that personality. They're funny. They're fun people. Thank you. Nothing happened. Damn it. I'll turn down this. This is too loud. Okay. Okay, why did nothing happen? Is this getting cold? Yes. Tell me more. Step to the next node. Just not gonna do that then? Did you crash? That's fine. Let's add a big break here. False. True. True. False. True. True. You're false then, huh? I bet it's that one. Because it's a high elevation. I bet it's not a moving prop. Like, yeah, like, what are you, really? Is there, like, I don't even know how to look this up. Okay, I need to get rid of the art level because it's in my way. I was missing entirely the wrong thing. No, you do have a moving prop. It's right there. Interesting. How do I debug this? I mean, I figure it's gotta be this one, because this one's different from the others. Is there anything that would make this one not trigger? You know, the easiest thing to do would be to just fucking put the box there. And then I don't have to debug a thing. Why are you visible? What the hell happened there? You're not ready yet. What the shit? Showing random boxes. Cool. Anyway, gameplay. God damn it, don't. Okay. Yeah, that should work. I'll save Sniper. Thanks, man.
I just did.
Save accomplished. Let's try this again. There's another option. The one that's false might. Okay. guess I'm doing the check. Before I'm updating the grid ID. Which is wrong. So, what I need to do. When slider has entered the volume. At that moment, bind something to the player pawn for when. No, because. When a slider enters the volume. Okay. On the event dispatcher, when you scream out, I entered the volume, also scream out what you are. Oops, slider. Can't I give you a variable? No. Yeah. Instigating actor. Fresh. Pass yourself as a reference. Okay. Fresh. If you've found the moving prop, or you're the instigating actor. You know what? I don't like this. I don't want this to go until the move is completed. What happens if this gets hit and the move completes in the same tick? Like you have a slow machine. That's why I feel like I should execute this immediately. But I don't do that on level complete and it's been fine, so. Because one will go before the other, right? On level complete, when a body enters the volume. Yeah, I add effects volume to activate after X form. That's the right way to do it. Okay. So on. This win condition. Yes. Say you have the instigating actor. You have the pawn. Activate this effects volume after the transform is completed. Pass yourself. This will get called when the transform completes, it'll call. Something like, I believe it called it activate. execute effect. But that's fine, I guess. There, that should do it. Sweet. Okay. Next thing. So when you beat that level, I want you to unlock the dance floor. That logic's all tied to the level completion node, which we're not using in this instance, so maybe I should put in a dummy level completion node and trigger it. That way I don't have to re-script everything. That'd be nice, right? Shouldn't do that, should I? I don't have to copy-paste, because what if I change this shit? Yeah, I'm gonna fucking cheese it, I think. There's just gonna be an invisible music stand in this level. And, fuck it. Hidden in game. No one ever has to know. Put it below the world. There. Okay, so now instead of calling level 1 on the player pawn, you're in this level, right? Show up. You are in this level. Don't be like this. We were cool, right? Can't we just be cool? You're not in this level. Move to this level. Save. There you go. Alright. Yeah, we're good. So. Activate. No, what was it? Effect? Execute effect. Now I can just update things here. So for this level, I want you to unlock this yet. Really? Maybe this is called generic Guatenrib? No. Damn it. And why are you showing again? Moreover, why are you broken? We will look at the dance floor momentarily. But first, so I don't have anything for when you unlock the dance floor, huh? Where is that? Somewhere is an enum with the unlockable stages. This is where you unlock the drummer, the accordion, blah blah blah. Let's unlock. Dance floor. Okay, so I will tell you to unlock the dance floor now in the UI. Worry about localization later, because this is not completely wrong, but sure as shit not really well organized. You've unlocked. Okay, so that'll be your pop-up. Next. Level select. Okay, dance. You are unlocked by only one cheating. Haha, okay. Well, now I need... It's in the game mode. This is where I set if various things are unlocked based on save stuff, so TA dance floor unlocked. And you'll know that's done by finding if sliding a four. If you found it and it's unlocked, or if that level's completed, you've unlocked the dance floor. The game mode will hold on to that logic. The UI will call that. If you've unlocked it, or you're cheating. Show the button. Alright, yeah. It's unlocked by default. That's not. Oh, no, that's right, because we completed the level. These levels are completed, so therefore the dance floor is unlocked. Good. It's already working, I think. If I delete my save. The dance floor is locked. Sweet. That's what I wanted to do. Alright. That was actually less painful. I don't know why I was dreading that. So, that's working. Why is every file dirty? What did I do? Let me close and reopen the editor. I need to get this back into a place where I can play it from beginning to end, and then push build to Steam and get feedback before I go too much further. I have to stop noodling on things like the dumb art stuff until at least people have played the puzzles. My deadline for that is Friday next week. That's what's gonna happen. Where's my pen? That's a more interesting problem. Okay, well, as soon as this is done saving everything in the game, I think the next thing we'll do is, there's the concept when you switch to, from one player to another, I want the riser to select, or the player that isn't selected kind of dims, and the player that is selected stays bright, and I want that to happen for the riser you're on as well. So actually maybe we'll stay and look at the dance floor briefly to get that to work. Wait, also, we're not really done here, because we've given the player no indication of what to do for that level. Like, I know you need to slide those up, but there's nothing that says to do that. Heh. Whoops. Oh, I'm sorry, Sniper. Hey, Rory. Hey, everybody. No. I have a build on Steam for... I think I've got 15 people that have activated it so far. So it's 15... Maybe, like... I've had a handful of people play it at Boston Indies and things. So maybe 20 people total have played the game. Which is appalling. But I mean... I know what I have to... They've been 20 really good people? I don't know. I have no excuse. I need to get this into more people's hands, but it's just too busted right now. Like, you literally couldn't win that level that I just did right there until now. And now, like, there's nothing that tells you... how to win that level. There's just no point in playtesting right now. I did... The other playtest I did before in the last build, I've added a lot of new stuff since then and changed a lot of stuff. And I need to finish fixing everything. How do I explain it? Usually when I make a game, you have these moments where you take everything and you tighten it up and you polish it, and then you have people play it, and then you break everything. Because you need to make wild changes, right? And you just kind of have that happening over and over on repeat. I think my ideal cadence would be like once a month. You should get the game back to a place where it's playable and you can give to somebody. I was keeping up with that, but last month I didn't, right? Just because there were so many changes. And I have an opportunity, like I'm getting lunch with some people on Friday. They probably won't actually play the game, but I'm using this as my excuse to make sure I get the game playable beginning to end by Friday next week. But yeah, it's essential, I agree. There will be more playtesting when it's further along. So what the hell? I should fix this. Maybe there should be, like, buttons that you just mash the things into. Right? No? I don't know. Why not? Yeah, and they like light up or something. How broken is the dance floor right now? Because the other thing is I need to figure out what the wind condition looks like on the dance floor. Which is completely bullshit right now. Like, I don't think any of this is really looking very good. Good, and the stands are gone. That's cool. So this is like the beginning of... I remember doing that. Okay, where are your, what happened? What the fuck? This shit again. That keeps on happening. just gonna delete you because I just don't trust you anymore. Okay, so moving prop grid based holds. Hey user, what's up, man? Wait, what's going on? Sorry, I haven't been reading. Will there be different skins for each bot? I'm really not planning that right now. That's like a lot of work for no reason. Maybe like if the game is successful, I'll put out like a DLC art pack. You know, like with hats and shit. Oh, this is a joke about loot boxes. My bad, sorry. My funny is off. This is too much crap in the screen. I stopped working on this because I was frustrated with how the art is not. It's like, I'll make a state. It's like, no, this is in the way. What a pain in the ass. Maybe if the lights were low. They have to be either really high or really low. Or they could be coming from this. I know how I could do it. Even that might be irritating. Could be a combination of both. What is this gonna look like? It's not gonna look like this. I need an artist. So you can at least see what's going on. It's not the first time this has happened. have this background music. Oh, do you guys hear it? You guys are probably hearing it way louder than me too. Yeah, whoops. Haha, sorry. Turn that down. Oh shit, my mic is really loud. Is it the AC? This is a test? Dude, what's going on with my mic? Are you... Okay. If you guys like it, I'll leave it on, my bad. Do I sound okay to you guys? Because OBS makes it look like my mic has got a shit ton of static. I'm listening to my own stream right now. This is, I don't know, mic check, I guess. Sure, that's fine. Fine. It's not a problem? Okay, cool, I'll leave it on. Sweet. This needs to be top down. This is too fucking busy. I know what color palette I want. I mean, it's gotta be blue. I don't know why I don't see your stand right now. Did it disappear suddenly? ASMR stream. Word. It's probably easier for me. Okay, so it's working. So the stands are gone in every level. That's also cool. To this. I'm just gonna assume you're busted too. Just be here. don't think I like this gate thing. I mean, I wanted to have some indication that you can't go off the edge of the world, but it looks hideous. I definitely can't have all these lights in the way. It's the cheesiest thing you can imagine. Prom under the sea. Oh, that's pretty bad. Dance floor. Prom dance floor. Do I have checkers? Resisting that real bad. I'll go for something like this. Not cheesy enough. Needs more cowbell. '80s night. I don't know if that would fit. That might run a little too counter to the jazz theme, La La Land stuff. Though to be fair, we should go back to our critical reference, La La Land dance scene. Oh yeah, well that's different. That's actually nice. It does illustrate a point, though. So I was thinking the dance floor would be like a stage, but maybe it should just be like, it pops up and then it's just the stars. If you want to really go for it. But there's a chance to go to the dance floor and you didn't decide to go out with Rue, at which point you're dancing alone. And that would be a little bit weird. You could dance alone under the stars. It's not that big of a deal. God, make it look different from everything else. It'd be nice and elegant though, but we do need obstacles for you to push off of. So if the world faded away, and it was just like you and the stars and the stage, the same way. I have to pull the stars in. The stars would have to be like right there. These would have to go. Alright, let's check in and then start playing a bit. This will be fun. This is too far away for you to push off of. I'm gonna make a different object for the obstacles in the dance stage, because I don't know what they'll be yet. Duplicate this. Dance floor. Sugar cane. Today, manually overwrite your materials. That's an affirmative. For these levels, because they're so raw, I don't have a separate art versus gameplay level set up for them yet. Definitely want like a spotlight. We definitely want like, you gotta know where you wanna go to win. I made this, but it's crap. This material, I didn't even touch the material. This is actually the back of the paper. It obviously won't actually be that. Don't think I want to go with wooden floor. I think I do want to do matte. Maybe let's start with this style. Let's duplicate this. The world space tiling material I'm using for combo levels. I don't want to like get this done. I just want to have a direction in mind. I could settle for that. You want to be warm brownish, you know? That looks like a wooden dance floor. Could work. I feel like we should try some other shit, though. Also, this isn't designed so that you can see the grid very well. I do want you to see the grid. Interesting, it's doing that. I see. Later, sniper. It's hard to imagine a dance floor that has wooden patterns. Oh, grid and wooden patterns. That's a little bit trickier, that's true. You made a comment on asking if I should become a nun. I just don't know how to take that, man. Gotta level with ya. Maybe it should just be a checkerboard. I should stop resisting. What are the obstacles? Thank you. had to choose between being a piano who could see the future or a chicken who could live forever, why wouldn't you answer that question about being a nun? Okay. That's pretty deep, man. I imagine if I had to choose between those two options, I would be busy deliberating between those two options, and therefore I wouldn't have the time to consider being a nun. I have nothing against nuns, or questioning your life goals. I think both are wise. But I imagine if I was busy, you know, deliberating between those two, that would take up a lot of my headspace. Because that's a perplexing question. That's the kind of decision I feel like you should take time with. What if the dance floor was a neon color with star? Not quite sure what you mean. What neon color are you thinking? Probably nothing is gonna come out of this today. I'm just playing. Ooh, I like the rich. See, I always go back to. I instinctively make the game too dark. Like, over and over and over, and I gotta stop it. I like that kind of richer color. The other thing is, keep in mind, the characters are that bright yellow, and the characters always, at the end of the day, this has to fall back. You have to be able to sense the grid. This has to fall back. The characters need to pop. The most saturated thing on the screen must always be the characters and the end location. These, I need to come up with a color with them or something. I don't know what I'm going to do yet for the sliding platforms. That's another question mark. I do feel like a pop of yellow might be nice here, though. Like, if the stars were yellow. Hey, William Cheer, what's up, man? Just messing around right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry, William. I didn't mean to go quiet when you got here. I figured you guys had fun talking. I thought if you were here, I wouldn't have to talk so much. I have no idea with what I'm gonna do with this part of the world, and I've been debugging different stuff lately, so it's kind of fun to take a break and just think about what I'm gonna eventually make it look like on a very high level. Wanna see some cool shit? I think it's cool. Oh shit, everything's broken. Give me a sec. Obstacle. Why would you possibly? For fuck's sake. Pretend everything isn't totally broken right here, but here's the new sliding house. It's all kind of busted. When you're done with all this, it unlocks the stage, which is super. I have no idea what I'm doing here yet. And then they can kind of like dance together. But I don't know what any of that's gonna look like. I don't know what any of this is gonna look like. Yet. So I just started kind of thinking about it. You had a problem earlier with a bug that happened only in the build and not the editor. I know that feeling well. Those suck. I used to constantly get ones. This is so stupid. It never occurred to me to, So when you play in Unreal, when you test a level, it's called. The fastest way to do it is called Pi, play an editor. That way you can like tune variables and things on the fly while the game is running. And it was always set up so that if you hit escape, it breaks you out of Pi. Turns out you can just change that. Which is like, I've had bugs, not only in this game, even in the Flame of the Flood. We would kick off a build, you'd play it, and then you'd be like, oh fuck, nobody checked escape. Because in editor, if you hit escape, it always breaks you out of Pi, but in game, obviously, that's probably gonna make you take you back a menu or something. So it should have occurred to me like several fucking years ago to keep on that to something else, and it never did. Womp womp. Learning to talk has been your most impressive achievement so far. Well, I mean, if you think about the amount of learning you do when you're young, and everything's very new, your brain is growing and such. I don't know. I'm not gonna say you're wrong. I don't think you're right. But hey, I'm not a fucking brain scientist. Maybe you're right. I will say most people have learned how to speak. Doesn't feel like an achievement. Hmm. Am I boring you guys? I could just go. This is the kind of stuff where I always feel weird streaming it. This is mostly what I do. Is just sit here and like think about shit. You were talking about Rory Bell. People still watch that. What? Thinking about shit? You can't really watch someone think. In this case, you can. Because I have no idea what I'm doing. You're watching me slowly break. This is not a day when I slowly break. I usually don't stream those days. Oh, you've streamed spreadsheets before. Yeah, but spreadsheets usually are interesting because there's like... It's so hard to see a designer work, and that's one of the few times you maybe can. Maybe. Oh, if it's playing spreadsheets, that's pretty boring. Yeah, that's kind of terrible. Yeah, I think I'm gonna be boring for a while, so I'm gonna go get a drink, put on some TV, and then I'll just keep aimlessly fucking around for the remainder of the night, and then hopefully I'll do something productive tomorrow. No, I need to get the game back to... By Friday, the game will be playable beginning to end. It's 9 o'clock on a Friday, so tonight I'm just gonna fuck around in Photoshop. You're getting your game... I feel like I repeatedly get the game playable from beginning to end. It'll stay that way for like... until enough people have playtested it that I'm convinced I need to change everything, and then it's fucking broken for a while again. So I'm sure this is a task that I will repeat many times. Block out the ending. Cool, dude. I think you and I think it a similar way, where if you make the art procedural enough, you can noodle with the design right up until the last day. You can keep blocking things out to a certain degree for a long time. The dumbest thing I did was stitch everything together into an overworld, because that really fucking makes it very difficult to iterate, and it's kind of fun, like it's kind of like a fun puzzle, but it's not something anybody will ever appreciate. Like, the players won't realize just how much goddamn work that was. And that's actually by far the most time-consuming part of designing all the levels, was figuring out how they fit together in that overworld. I got it, dude. You're bringing in a designer? That's cool. Yeah. I know that feeling very well. I mean, you get that way with everything, right? Not just the project, but every part of the project. Like, when I animate, after I've been animating for long enough, I just don't see it anymore. It just becomes, like, technical stuff. Like, is it technically correct? You lose sight at the high level. think it's cool you're getting to that place where you can hire people up, though, and you can finish that. Because you're shipping spring next year? Yeah, I didn't anticipate. So, I've never worked on a puzzle game before, in any capacity. How do I put it? In any other game, the levels are locked down much, much earlier. Because so much of the experience isn't the levels. You know what I mean? Whereas the game you're making is entirely the levels, so obviously they're not going to be locked down until very late. And then there's... I don't know how to explain it. Like, that part of design tends to get locked down almost before anything else, because everything else is balanced around it. And you noodle things, like cover height, where cover goes a little bit, but every time you move something after, at some point you need to put the pencil down so the artist can finish. It's just such a different cadence. I feel like with a shooter especially, it's very clear, like this gets locked down and then this and then this and then this, whereas like with a puzzle game, nothing's locked down necessarily, because it can't be, because the entire experience is the puzzle. And the puzzle is all of it, right? Like the art, the actual design of the puzzle and so forth. Though I have to admit, I think it's horrifying you're still designing levels. It's close. Okay. But that could just be I'm not used to this. And so much of your art is built to be so procedural. Like, the way you built that was very... It was creative in that way. Alright. I'm gonna head out, too. Thanks for dropping by, Lynn. Cool. I assume everybody in my... The small number of people in my chat all know William Cheer is making a sweet-ass puzzle game. And... You guys should all be following him, I figure. Probably. I hope. Yeah, thanks for dropping in then. And thanks everybody else for swinging by. Sweet. Bye.